Hello, I'm Mike. You've probably heard of Andrej Karpathy, one of the top AI minds in the world. He recently spent weeks vibe coding a new app called MenuGen that visualizes restaurant menus. Today, I'm going to take his ideas, solve a useful problem, and build an AI app from scratch in under 5 minutes with no codes, and I'm going to show you how. So I jammed with AI for 30 seconds. What if we built a menu match app? You upload a menu, pick your diet, keto, vegan, whatever, and it tells you exactly what to get.
Ah, that sounds like a really fun idea. It'd be super handy, especially when you go out to eat and you're trying to figure out what you can order that fits your diet.
That's exactly what we're building. And instead of using Cursor like Karpathy used, we're going to use a tool called Lovable. As you'll see here from this Google Trends chart, you'll see that Cursor had a massive peak back here, but then eventually Lovable caught up and has even overtaken Cursor in popularity. In this video, you'll find out why that is, and Menu Match is what we're building. The clock starts now. Create a clean single-page app called Menu Match. It needs a large headline, a subheadline, a button to upload a menu image, and a section below to display AI recommendations. Now, this is what Karpathy called the strong hook, seeing a website materialize fast, but unlike his experience, we're not going to be 20% done once this prompt is finished. With the right tool, like this one, we'll already be halfway there. Oh snap, that was easy. Look at this. Menu match, choose your menu image, and you'll get AI recommendations down here. Yep, as a non-technical person that couldn't do this stuff before, it feels like we've made amazing progress, right? Now add a drop-down menu with these options: keto, vegan, gluten-free, low-carb, and a large get my recommendation button. The next prompt is spinning into action, and my dreams are about to become reality on the screen in front of me. Here it is, it's just updated, and now we have dietary preferences as a drop-down menu in our app and the Get My Recommendation button ready to go. This is the easy part, but as Karpathy rightly pointed out, this is where the real trouble starts, connecting APIs and databases and even eventually payment to make this app into a business. Well, we solved that entire headache in weeks 2 and 3 of my new course. If you want to learn how to power an app like this, you can check the link in the description. Now, bear in mind, we've got a beautiful looking app, but choosing a menu image, clicking it doesn't do anything, and also dropping down and choosing a diet preference, I don't get the chance to click this button. Well, this is where Andrej had a problem navigating around convoluted menus to integrate with AI, having his AI hallucinate and not connect OpenAI's ChatGPT. I'll just simply prompt Lovable to use these tools and watch how it does the magic. When the user clicks choose menu image, they should be able to upload an image file or take a photo with a camera on their mobile device. And when they click get my recommendation, we're going to use OpenAI image analysis to analyze the menu and extract all menu items. Finally, AI will analyze each dish against the diet criteria selected, rank the recommendations with explanations, show nutritional estimates, and also suggest modifications such as skip the croutons or ask for sauce on the side. Let's run this prompt. Now you can see Lovable is getting straight to work. I'll help you implement the image upload functionality with camera support and set up OpenAI for you. So unlike an experienced developer like Andrej Karpathy, who had spent weeks wrangling spaghetti APIs and AIs hallucinating, Lovable is going to do it all for us in moments. Now look at that, in moments it's given a place to enter your OpenAI API key. All users can do that. Obviously that's not ideal in a production app, and we'd store it in the back end. I cover that in detail in my course, but for now we'll use this as a minimum viable product prototype, and I'll show you how to get that API key. Over here in the OpenAI playground, we just create a key, and I'll call it menu match, and we'll create that secret key. Now we just copy the key. Now, just a slight break. Lovable has actually told me that the index file is getting rather long and you should consider asking me to make it into smaller, more manageable components. We don't need to worry about what that means. We just ask Lovable to do it and it makes our app more efficient. Here we go. It's refactoring all the code, which basically means it's breaking everything down into smaller files like recommendations list, image preview, and of course the index file that'll be nice and snappy. Now we can pop this in a new window, everything looks good, but I want to use it on my mobile device when I'm out and about, so let's load it there. Okay, first I'm going to put in my OpenAI API key, which I copied to the clipboard, and then I have the possibility here to click and take a photo. Look at that, my phone is immediately activating the camera, and I can just put this menu up to it and take the photo, so let's do so. And now we've got a photo of the menu, let's use the photo. Now my photo's in the app, I can select a dietary preference, so let's go for keto here, and then all that's left to do is click get my recommendation. And look at this, it seems to be finished, and now I can see all my recommendations with exactly the guide of what I should order from the menu. This is fantastic. So look at this, within moments, I just drag and drop my menu, scroll down, there's my uploaded menu, then I select a preference, maybe vegan this time, get my recommendation. Boom, there we go, we've got vegan suggestions in an instant from AI right here, even with suggested modifications and the nutritional info. Now, an app isn't an app until it's launched on the web. With a developer, this could take days, maybe even weeks, but for us, it'll take seconds. Okay, let's go back here to Lovable, and you'll see there is a big publish button up here in the top right. Just click this, choose the name for the idea of your app. So I'm actually going to call it Menu Match, like so. Rename the project. You'll see it's menu-match.lovable.app. Now you can add a custom domain, so no DNS, no need to work at the command line. Lovable will do that for you too. And then you click publish. And look at that, it's shipped. It's there, it's live on the web. You can visit this link and bring your own OpenAI API key and test this app out for yourself. Maybe in the future, I'll go ahead and add a database. I'll put my own API key in there and allow you to buy credits to use Menu Match for your own dining out experiences. In 5 minutes, we deconstructed an expert's idea, built on it, launched it live on the web with zero code whatsoever. The promise of AI is absolutely real. You can build things stuck in your head, and this video for you should be the proof. But remember that a simple app is one thing, an app with user accounts, a scalable database, a payment system, a marketing engine is a business. And if you're ready to stop being a dreamer and actually start being a builder, you want to check out my Ship Your App in 4 weeks course. It's guided, it's hands-on. I'm there to guide you every step of the way, and you can click the link in the description down below to join the waitlist, and we can build your future together. Thanks so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.